Hello, welcome to Toronto Bible Study. Today we're going to look again at Pastor Vince Miller, who I think is Vince Miller. So he's another false teacher Calvinist guy, but I don't know. He requires more attention because he seems to be quite popular and he's getting quite a lot of attention. So he needs to be exposed. So we're going to take a look at him, another look at him. He has a video here dedicated to free will. Because, you see, as I said, the Calvinists, they try to avoid discussing issues related to their Calvinism so that people don't realize what they are. So most of the time, you won't even know that they're Calvinists. You know, you just think, oh, they're just a regular Christian. But now he's doing this. So now we can discuss that issue. So let's see what he's got. Okay. All this is Freemason up, all this stuff.
Hey everybody, this is Vince Miller. Thank you so much for joining me for this segment. Ask Pastor Vince. I do my best to answer your questions in 3 minutes or less. Someone wrote in this last week and asked me, hey Vince, me and my friend were having a debate at the lunch table one day, and we were debating the topic of free will. Can you please answer this question? Do we have the freedom of will to choose Christ or not? Great question. So here's the good news. You do have free will. Here's the bad news. You always choose to do what is wrong.
Every time.
You always choose to do what is wrong. Every single time.
Some Calvinists, most Calvinists will agree to this. Some Calvinists will try to deny it because it's ludicrous. If you think about it, it's absurd, right? Even people who are unsaved, even Christians who think, if they're Christians, think that they're better than the unsaved people because they have the Holy Spirit or something. Well, even you, Christian, who thinks he's better than unsaved people, look at the unsaved people. Do they really never do the right thing? Never? They never do anything right? Is that true? You've never seen an unsaved person do something nice for somebody else? Or just do something unselfish? You never seen that? So that's why it's just ludicrous. The guy's trying to get you to believe that unsaved people cannot do anything good. They always choose to do the wrong thing. Oh, in any given choice, in every choice between right and wrong, they always choose wrong. Does that make any sense to you? Does that make any sense? No, it's foolishness. Yes, the unsaved are slaves to sin. And the saved, they have a chance to overcome their sin. But that doesn't mean that the unsaved are always going to do sin. And it doesn't mean that the saved are always going to be overcoming sin. Not always.
It makes us really uncomfortable because we want to have the moral authority or power to be able to do what is right and be justified by our actions, don't we? We do. But there's a lot of things in life you don't get to choose. Like, you don't get to choose the day you're going to be born, the day you're going to die, how you're going to die, what you look like, what family you're born in, what country you're born in. You don't get to choose a lot of things. But we want to be...
We don't get to choose those things, but we do get to choose between right and wrong. You know, you're on the bus. You see somebody left their wallet on the seat. You can either keep that wallet or try to find that guy and give him back his wallet. All right? Right or wrong? Now, you know in your heart that there's many times when you had that choice, that option, right or wrong, and you've chosen wrong. There's also many times when you've chosen right. That was the case before you became a Christian, and it's the case since you became a Christian. Doesn't mean that since you're a Christian, you always do the right thing. And doesn't mean that when you were a non-Christian that you always did the wrong thing. It's ludicrous. This whole theology is nonsense. But watch how they do it. Because based on that, now they're going to say that you can't choose to believe the gospel.
to choose this thing, don't we? Because we believe in our minds that we can be morally good and morally justified by our own actions, but that's simply just not the case.
See, that's the thing. So that's not what we're saying. We're saying we're justified by faith, okay? Not by actions. That's works, right? See how they flip it like that? This is not because he's just confused and he doesn't get it. He's deliberately deceiving you, okay? Because he's like part of the program to keep you into Calvinism and to kind of not make you understand how ludicrous it is. Okay? So he's like, oh, we can't save ourselves. No, we're not trying to save ourselves by our actions. We're saying we're gonna save ourselves by faith. Faith is not a work, okay? Faith is not an action. It's just in your head. Repentance, even repentance, metanoia, it's a change of mind, okay? Or anyway, we can get into that, but whatever.
Paul said this wasn't the case. In Romans 3:23, he says this. He says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Paul says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That doesn't mean they never do the right thing, okay? Everyone has sinned. Yes, we've all sinned. Does that mean that we never do the right thing? No, it doesn't mean that. It's what nonsense. So that's the kind of foolishness. I mean, excuse me. I mean, this guy, there's much better verses. If you want to try to push the lie of Calvinism, the lie that we're totally depraved or whatever, there's many, many, many much better Bible verses he could have chosen. Okay? So it just shows how he doesn't know the Bible. He can't even lie with the Bible properly. He doesn't have the skills to use the Bible for his lies. He has to do, even that he does it at a weak, like, elementary level.
Everyone has sinned and everyone falls short. Therefore, no one has the moral authority to stand on their own feet or on their own ground.
That's again, we're not saying that we're trying to stand on our own feet or stand on our own ground. No Christian is trying to say that. That's the straw man, okay? The straw man. He gives you a fake argument as if we're trying to say that we stand on our own feet and stand on our own ground. No, we stand in the grace of Jesus Christ. We access that grace through faith, which is from us, Romans 5:2, okay? We have our faith and we access the grace. And then we stand in it, okay, by faith, okay, by faith, not by actions, not by works, by faith. So all this stuff is lies.
We just can't do it. Now, here's the good news. God has a different kind of free will. He's got the kind of free will that always chooses to do what is right and righteous, and he sees us in our state, and he chooses for us. He chooses for us.
He chooses for us. Where does it say that in the Bible? He doesn't bring a Bible verse now. Where's the Bible verse? How come you don't have a Bible verse? How come you had Romans 3:23 before, which doesn't even prove what you're trying to say? But now when you're saying this thing, oh, God chooses for us? He chooses for us? Because when I read the Bible, he says, choose to the people. Choose this day. Evil or good, life or death.
And therefore justifies us by his choice. And guess what his choice was? His choice is that Jesus Christ would come into life itself, live a holy life, and die righteously for our sin.
This is how they try to make you think that they're trying to teach you the gospel. Because they talk about Jesus and stuff. Oh, Jesus died for our sins, and that's the gospel, right? That's part of the gospel message. But he's not telling you the real gospel, which is you have to believe that and then you're saved and then you don't need this fool. He's going to say, oh, well, okay, yeah, that all happened. Jesus died for your sins and all that. And also God had to choose you from the beginning of the world. And now you have to persevere in the saints or something. Persevere, otherwise you're not really saved. Okay? That's why this is all just a lie. Lie of the devil.
To heal this issue, to provide a resolution to this issue. In fact, Romans 3:24, which comes right after Romans 3:23, aren't you glad you showed up today to discover that? But it says this, it says, and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. In other words, while we are sinful people, and we fall short of the glory of God, we can be justified by his grace as a gift. It's a gift for Jesus. In other words, by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. In other words, while...
Wait. Let me just see. Because that's some bad translation and everything too, right? But justified by his grace. Romans, what was that? Was it Romans 3:24? See, there's no gifts. There's no gifts here in this one. You see? For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. We're justified freely by his grace. Yeah, freely. Okay, it's a gift. Freely. We're justified freely. But what he's trying to say, you're not understanding. Like, this is where they're mixing up the terms, okay? Before he said that God had to choose you to believe. This is the thing. Do you have the ability to believe the gospel by yourself without God telling you? They say no, but they can't prove it in the Bible. He shows you Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Yes, we all sin. Does that mean we can never do the right thing? Think about it yourself. Before you became a Christian, did you never do the right thing? You never did anything right? Never? Does that make any sense? That's foolishness. Obviously, the atheists, the Muslims, the Hindus, they're not a bunch of psychopathic monsters who just kill and destroy everything they do. No, they have families. They give to charity. They volunteer at food banks and stuff. They're not monsters, okay? They all sin. We all sin. But none of us are perfect. But none of us, that's why we can't go to heaven, because we're not perfect. Not because we're so unrepentantly evil, total depravity. None of that is true. None of that is in the Bible, and none of that is anything you need to worry about. Don't listen to these people. These people are beyond evil. You guys don't even know.
We are sinful people, and we fall short of the glory of God. We can be justified by his grace as a gift. It's a gift from him through the redemption that's in Christ Jesus. And that's the good news, is that God chooses you by his free will. Now, the good part about this is he also extends to us a gift, the Holy Spirit that dwells in us. So as a believer, we can listen.
How come he doesn't show you where in the Bible it says God chooses you? Okay, now there's some stuff like, yeah, Jesus says, you did not choose me, I chose you. Okay, who is he talking to? Is he talking to the church, or is he talking to the 12 in John 14 or something? That's the kind of thing they try to pull out, okay? But right now, he didn't pull out any Bible verse. Because there's no Bible verse that says God makes people believe the gospel. That's what they need to really prove their thing. You need to see a Bible verse or a story where God literally makes someone believe the gospel. It doesn't happen. So they don't have a case. They don't have anything to support their theology. It's just a bunch of nonsense. The only reason they're still alive is because they have enough money and enough people who are under their spell that they can keep it going. And the thing is, people would rather believe a comforting lie than believe the truth. You know, or they'd rather believe, or, you know, people would just rather believe this than believe that the truth, that all they have to do is believe the gospel and live. Yeah, you believe this guy, you're not going to live. You're not going to go to heaven. This guy's not going to heaven. These guys are completely lost.
And we can heed or obey its voice, and we can keep in step obediently, living a moral life, yet still
What?
A gift, the Holy Spirit that dwells in us. So as
we
fall short of the glory of God, we can be justified.
Okay, everyone falls short
through the redemption.
So this is the thing. So justified by his grace as a gift. So it's justified by his grace freely. That's what it says, right? But justified as a gift. Let's say justification is a gift. Okay. Where does it say he made us believe the gospel? That's the thing. That's the critical thing. Okay. Who how do you believe the gospel? Is it because you heard it and then you believed it, or is it because God made you believe it? If it's because God made you believe it, then these people are right. But this, that's obviously not true. They don't have any Bible verse, nothing. Okay. So they try to quickly talk to you. This is all con man stuff. I can't believe people fall for this. This is pure con man tactics he's doing. Okay. He just quickly shows you the Bible verse quickly and then it's gone. He doesn't discuss in depth the theology or anything. He's just gonna give you this, oh yeah, he's like smiling, and oh yeah, you know, half of humanity is going straight to hell. They can't help it. He doesn't tell you any of that stuff. They're just gliding over everything. Okay, I don't know, man. If you like to believe this stuff, that means you don't care about the truth. You like to believe just this easy lie, the comforting lie, rather than the uncomfortable truth, you know?
That is in Christ Jesus. In other words, while we are sinful people and we fall short of the glory of God, we can be justified by his grace as a gift. It's a gift from him through the redemption that's in Christ Jesus. And that's the good news, is it?
Yeah, grace is a gift, okay? How do you get to the grace? Through faith. Faith is not a gift. You have to have faith. You have to come up with faith, okay? It's from you. You just believe it. It's like, obviously, how could somebody make you believe? Why would he tell you to believe the gospel? Why would God command you to believe the gospel, which we are commanded to in the Bible, right? Why are we commanded to believe the gospel if we can't unless God makes us? Does it make any sense for God to command us to do something that we cannot do? No, it's ludicrous.
God chooses you by his free will. Now, the good part about this is he also extends to us a gift.
God chooses you. So what he's saying is God chooses you. So then God doesn't choose everyone else, that they just go to hell? They just go to hell. God didn't choose them. So what? I thought God loves everyone. What happened? These guys are going to try and say, oh yeah, God loves everyone, but still he sends the rest of them to hell. He just chose those guys to go to heaven. Everyone else is going to hell. No one can help it. It's got nothing to do with them. It's just a matter of God chose them. So God chose them, not because they're good, not because they believe the gospel, just because he felt like it. These guys, they're going to hell. Not because they're bad, or not. They're not any worse than those people. They're bad, yeah, but they're not any worse than them. But they're going to hell. Just because God didn't feel like making them believe the gospel. He just didn't feel like it. He didn't like it. He didn't like
the Holy Spirit that dwells in us. So as a believer, we can listen to that Holy Spirit, and we can heed or obey its voice, and we can keep in step obediently, living a moral life, yet still justified by his gift of grace. Well, I hope that answers your question today and gives you some hope that
what
dwells in us. So as a believer, it's a gift from him through the redemption, as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. In other words, while we are sinful people and we fall short of the glory of God, we can be justified by his grace as a gift. It's a gift from him through the redemption that's in Christ Jesus. And that's the good news, is it?
Yeah, the redemption is a gift, okay? Not the faith, though. This is just confusing you, okay? He's not helping you to understand this very complex issue. He's giving you this easy answer. You can take this, okay, so all I have to do is listen to the Holy Spirit in my heart, and that's all I got to do. No, you don't have the Holy Spirit if you think this fool. You think, if you even, like, this is not the gospel, so how do you have the Holy Spirit? Maybe you heard the gospel somewhere else before, and then you got confused and you came here. Maybe. Even then, if you're so confused, you know, you're saved, but you're so confused that you got caught up in this, well, you're not listening to the Holy Spirit very well. Okay, so you're not very well in contact with that.
God chooses you by his free will. Now, the good part about this is he also extends to us a gift, the Holy Spirit that dwells in us. So as a believer, we can listen to that Holy Spirit, and we can heed or obey its voice, and we can keep in step obediently, living a moral life, yet still justified by his gift of grace. Well, I hope that answers your question today and gives you a...
You don't live a moral life. This guy's living a moral life, okay? These guys are complete con men, liars, false teachers, heretics, okay?
Hope that While you do make some bad choices, God makes good choices.
And he's like a Freemason or something, for sure. All this stuff, all these little hats and everything, give me a break, man. This symbolism and stuff.
For us, to help us to understand that his grace is better than any choice we could ever make. If you have a question, write in to me at vince@beresolute.com.
His grace is better than any choice we could ever make. That's true. But we can't even access his grace unless we make the choice to do so through faith, okay? You access the grace by faith, okay? So you must have faith. It's only if you believe, obviously, only if you believe in Jesus can you ask him to save you, right? So you need faith to access the grace, obviously. You think you're gonna, and why would he, again, For the silly Calvinists who are going to try and tell me that God makes you believe, that's why you can access the grace. Well, why would he command us to believe the gospel if we can't believe it on our own? It doesn't make sense. It's like telling somebody, hey, go fly to France, not in a plane, just fly there on your own with your own power of flight, okay? Now, we know people can't fly, so it doesn't make any sense for me to say to someone, fly to France with your own power, okay? And also, it wouldn't make any sense for me to say, okay, it's a crime now in Canada for anyone to not fly to the store when they have to go to the store. No one should walk to the store, they should fly. Would that make any sense? Because no one can fly, so then no one could go to the store. It doesn't make any sense. No one would do that. That's why God would not tell you to believe the gospel if you can't do it on your own. Okay? I don't know. Maybe I'm coming off like an asshole here. But look, this is crazy, guys. These people are so bad. You have to be able to see that this person is not trying to explain the thing to you properly. That he's just running through all the important information. Quickly dealing with this very complex issue. Oh, I'm going to answer it in 3 minutes. The question of free will that Christians and Calvinists are debating all over the world for centuries. He's going to answer it in 3 minutes. It's because it's not the right answer. It's just the thing to shut you up so you don't think anymore. He's trying to dumb you down so you don't think about this. Okay? Because if you think about it, you'll realize that they're teaching you nonsense. Anyway. So don't listen to these people, guys.
Org, I'll
seriously.
Do my best to answer it.
These people are very, very bad. Oh, I'll give you my best answer in 3 minutes. Look, get out of here, man. Those are clowns, man. Don't listen to these people, okay? They are wicked beyond belief. Beyond belief. They are not Christians. They're teaching you a false gospel. If you think you're saved because of whatever they taught you, you're probably not even saved. Okay, you need to understand what the real true gospel is, which is believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. We could talk about that. So you have to believe the certain gospel facts, such as 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4. Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus paid your sin debts. Okay, those things. You believe those things, you're saved. Okay, you don't need these fools. You don't need any of that. Anyway, okay. Toronto Bible study. God bless you. Hallelujah.